I always say love is a conscious decision.
I'm a firm believer that love isn't a feeling, it's a commitment.
My version of love is friendship. And then, hey, can you be my friend when we raise another human being?
We stumbled into each other's lives like 2 years ago. He was throwing a party, and then he asked me to guest DJ. I was like, oh, this is my opportunity.
Well, he didn't actually get to propose because I found the ring.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. And yeah. Once I had it on my finger, I didn't want to take it off.
It was Saab who made the first move?
No, that's not true. You were super leaning into me like that, like watching the laptop, and you were being like, like no segue.
And my mom took a liking to Iman, and I was like, wow, I guess this is the one.
In-laws are important.
With love for me before, it was very complicated. With Mike, it was just so easy, and I've never felt that before.
I think the true test of love is when he super annoys me and I still want to be with him. When he leaves the toothpaste cap off or his contact lens case open and it's fine with me. That's how I can tell I love you so much.
He just changed me like in a lot of ways and has made me into a better person.
I think I appreciated our love so much more when we became parents because I felt like if I was with the wrong person, this would be so much harder. He was really, really, like not even a cliche, like my rock. Yeah.
I'm usually very like high-strung and I like to control everything. And I would see comments on Instagram, of course. People think he's hot, whatever. And I'm always insecure about that because I don't know who's DMing him.
He's very, very kind, very nice, and he doesn't have any ulterior motives or hidden intentions, but the women do sometimes. And so in the beginning, I didn't communicate it, but I kept it inside. And I keep all my hurt inside, and I just take it and take it, and I'd smile, and I'd be the nice one, and I'd never blow up at him until finally I'd had enough, and I was really, really hurt, and I exploded, and that was our first fight.
What we went through is, you know, it's not meant for humans to go through alone. We were expecting twins, and one of the twins did not make it. So we had to deal with a newborn, and at the same time, we had to grieve. But at the end of the day, even in the worst of times, we still found a moment that we could sit together and laugh. And that, for me, is the ultimate affirmation that, you know, we really do love each other and, you know, we're meant for each other.
Sometimes you'll hate each other, like be at each other's throats, want to kill each other, but at the end, you'll get past that, fall in love again, you know?
Well, I guess love has no colors. Doesn't matter if it's two guys, two girls, a guy and a girl. As long as it's genuine, it's true. It's love.
Love is always so romanticized by everyone, but love is tough. And it's probably the biggest struggle you'll ever have to go through in your life, and it'll pose the biggest challenges you'll ever face. But at the same time, it's the most rewarding thing ever once you work through all of it, and it's well worth all the downtimes.
Love rules if you love yourself.
Love sucks if you're not doing it right.
Love rules because you have a partner through everything, the ups, downs, and every stage of your life. A partner in crime.
And love sucks because you're gonna hurt each other and you're gonna feel down, but it's worth it in the end.
Love sucks because sometimes you have to compromise yourself for the one you love.
Love rules because if it's true love, you get to be yourself and I get to be with you.
Celebrity chef Sasha Tran and her fiancé Brandon Choi.
You're a piece of shit!
I should have never let you in. You were a complete waste of my time.
Remind me why you never got together?
There's way too much history there.
You don't want to wonder what if.
I'm so embarrassingly in love with you.
Tell her how you feel, son.